Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and today we're gonna create a part modeling tutorial using the totally free version of Onshape. Now, this part model is gonna come from the website tootalltoby.com/leaderboard, and this is a website that I've set up where people can challenge themselves to speed model these three parts, and once they're done, their time will automatically be posted here on a leaderboard. So we can see here currently the leader is Airwick, who did all three models in just 3 minutes and 12 seconds using Onshape. Very impressive, much faster than I'm gonna be able to do these in. But what's cool is that I can click on this link here to watch the video that Airwick submitted of his speed run. And so I can learn, you know, I can see what type of workflows he's using and what type of tools he's using. And that really helps me to get better and get faster with the software. So what I'm gonna be doing today is gonna be this third model. I've already done part one and part two, so this is really part three in this three-part series. If we click on this banner here that says April Speed Modeling Challenge, it'll take us to an IMGUR page where all three of these drawings are posted. So if you wanna practice or try this out as well, you are welcome to do so just by going to tootalltoby.com/leaderboard. I'm gonna move that over to my second screen, and then here in the middle of the page, I'm gonna click Compete. This is where the clock comes up, and really what you're supposed to do is model one, model two, model three, all in a row, but I'm just doing them one at a time to make these tutorials. And of course, if you see me doing anything along the way that I could be doing better, be sure to let me know down in the comments.
Ow!
Okay, so here we are in the document manager in Onshape. I've got the clock here in the background. Let me just kind of slide this over. Again, normally you would do model one, model two, model three right in a row, but for today's tutorial, I'm just doing them one at a time. I've got my IMGUR here over on the second page, and before I get started, I'm just gonna come up with a basic game plan for this model. So first of all, I wanna take note that this model is in inches, and I wanna make sure that I have my document workspace set up with the correct units. I wanna just kinda come up with a basic game plan as far as the order of feature creation. So for me, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start out by creating this shape here, and then extruding it to the 1.8 inches that's called out down here in this view. Then after I've got that basic shape, I'll probably come in with a cut extrude or a remove extrude here to remove this little pocketed area. And then I think I'll finish off by creating this counterbore and these holes over here. So it's always good to come up with just a basic strategy, but then you maybe also want to start thinking about some nuances of that strategy. Like in Onshape, before I can create a counterbore, Onshape likes it if I've got a point that I can reference for that counterbore. So maybe when I make my first extrusion, instead of going up and away from the top plane, I want to go down, because if I create that first extrusion going down, then that sketch will be here on the top plane, and I'll have that point right here waiting for me when it comes time to do the counterbore. So these are a little bit more nuanced strategies that you can start thinking about, but they can save you a lot of time on the tail end if you kind of go into this thing with a game plan. So now I'm gonna move this over to my second screen. I'm gonna start the clock and let's get into it here. I'm gonna create a new document. I'll just call this one 03. And for this document, I'm gonna start out with the top plane. I'm gonna press the S key on my keyboard and begin a sketch. Then I'll press the N key to get normal two. And then I will press the S key again to get into the line command. And I'm gonna once again use this line come back, okay? Don't touch anything on your mouse. Just kind of come back, hold your mouse over the endpoint, go into an arc, come back around with another line here. There we go. You can, if you look around a little bit, you can get tangent on that one. And then come back again and hold your mouse over the endpoint, and then come away from that endpoint with a tangent arc. So that's a great workflow, and one that I'm really happy to see now is present in Onshape. Then I'm gonna do a crossing select over these two entities, and I'll press T on my keyboard, which adds the tangency relationship. I can take this point and drag it onto that point there. I can select these two points here and press H to get those two points to be horizontal. And then I can jump into the dimension command and dimension this with a radius of, whoops, I forgot to change my units to inches, right? Well, I can type in a radius here of 1.25 and then type the letters IN on my keyboard, enter. And then I can type in a radius or define a radius here of 0.5 IN on my keyboard, and I can press enter. And then I can type in a distance here from this center point to this center point, a distance here of 2 IN, and I can press enter on my keyboard. And then after I do that, I can exit that sketch and change. See, when you go in here to the workspace units, you go to this hamburger menu and you go to this workspace units, it's gonna kick you out of the sketch. So now I can change that to inches and hit the green check mark. And if I were to go back into that sketch, we can see that everything has updated and now it is in the correct units, and I was able to use the correct sizes by typing in that IN. So now I can jump into an extrude command, and this is gonna extrude to a height of 1.8 inches, and I can press enter to update the preview. And then, like I mentioned in the game plan, I'm going to reverse the direction on this so that I've got this point here that I can use when it comes time to creating my counterbore. So I'll hit the green check mark there. That sets me up nicely to jump to the front plane and to begin a sketch. So I'll press the S key and begin a sketch, press the N key to get normal two, press the S key to get into a rectangle command. So we'll create a rectangle like so. We're gonna jump into the fillet command here, and we're gonna create a fillet here on this corner and on this corner. And then we can left click to finish that fillet command and then input the radius there of 0.1. Now we can go into our dimension command and create a dimension that goes from here to here with a value of 0.25. And we can create a dimension from here to here with a value of 0.25 as well. And then we can create a dimension that goes from here across to here with a value of 1.75. And just to make sure that this sketch is nice and tidy, I might once again pick this point and then pick this point here and press V on my keyboard to make those two vertical. So now I'm ready to jump into my extrude command, and this is gonna be a remove so that it functions as a cut. And this is gonna be a through all, and we want this to go in both directions. So we're gonna hit the check mark here for symmetric. So it goes through all in both directions. So now that we've got that geometry looking pretty good, we can hit the green check mark, and we've got our cut extrude over here on this end. So S key, create a sketch. This one's pretty straightforward. We just create a sketch of a circle here, and we give that a dimension of 0.5, and that's gonna be an extrude cut, remove, and through all. And there we go. And now we can finish up by adding in our hole. So there is a hole feature here in Onshape. We can find that hole feature. My menus are a little bit snug here. Let me just make this a little wider. There it is. So there's the hole feature. And I'm gonna say that this is gonna be a counterboard hole with a through diameter of 1, with a larger counterbore diameter of 1.5, and with a counterbore depth of 0.25. And so now we can see here that we need to locate that. And so let's show our original sketch, since that original sketch has a point on it. And that way we can just click right on that point. That gives us a counterbore, and this thing is looking good. So we can hide that sketch. We don't really need to see the planes anymore. If you want bonus points, you can right mouse button on the model, and you can go to edit appearance for part 1, and you can make it the same color as it is here on the drawing. That really doesn't help you at all, and there's no reason to do that when you're running against the clock. It's just kind of a flex that you can do if you really want to show off how good you are in the software. We can also go in here to our, I'm gonna go back into my workspace units just because I'm creating a custom material, and so I want to create this using millimeters and grams. So that way when I go here to assign material, I can assign this material using what's on the title block, which is 0.0027. So just wanna make sure that I could assign that custom material using the same value that's on the title block. And then I'll finish up here by once again going to my workspace units and changing this to pounds. That way when I go into the mass properties for this part, I'm looking at this mass properties and it's coming out at 0.686. And when we look at the print, that is the correct value. So I'm gonna click here to stop the model. 5 minutes and 31 seconds. So on all three of my models, I was right there around the 5 minute range, which I think is pretty good. You know, it's not horrible. It's not amazing or anything, but let me know down in the comments what you thought about today's tutorial. Let me know if this was helpful for you. Let me know if you saw anything that I was doing that I can maybe do a little bit more efficiently or effectively. I'm capturing all the notes that you guys are sharing with me, and I'm using them to help me get even better and better and stronger in this software. So I really appreciate it. And if you appreciate these types of videos, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and of course, be sure to come back for the next episode. I'll see everybody there.